Welcome to our show. I think we all know you by now.
My kids not being there for them. Fuck. My kids, yeah, sex work.
Who taught you sex work?
My biological mother.
Okay. Hello. How are you today?
I'm very good. How are you?
I'm very good. Welcome to our show. Our guest today is none other than Sam Gelisiwe. I think we all know you by now.
Yeah.
How do you describe yourself? You are a reality star. What three words would you use to describe yourself at this point? Because you are famous.
I'm no longer that person. Yeah. I'm not famous. I'm just a normal girl. I'm just a normal trying girl. To live a normal life now. I'm no longer a TV star. What Twitter, the work that I was doing.
Yeah.
Not anymore.
Okay.
I'm just in gym.
It's just you.
Mm-hmm.
And yet it seems to be following you.
Everywhere I go. Can I speak Zulu?
Well, of course you can.
Oh, there's this saying, Guti, if you make a mistake, it's going to follow you. It's going to haunt you forever. As much as Unkulunkulu can like literally forgive you and be like, yeah, cool.
Yeah.
But like it's going to be
there
forever.
Mm.
So it's something that I have to live with or just limit myself. Guti, let me just not go outside and be like, be that person and just under the radar.
When you say mistakes, what mistakes are you talking about? You're 27 now?
Mm-hmm. So
what mistakes have you made in your 27 years
mm-hmm.
on earth? What mistakes do you think you've made?
The first mistake was following my beliefs, my values, the things that were taught to me that I thought were normal or just NG. So that was my first mistake. My second mistake was not following the my profession.
Yes.
And actually pursue something so that I can get love from someone.
Yeah.
My kids not being there for them. Fuck. My kids, yeah. NG. Not going back to school. Yeah, the life that I've, like, people's validation, everything,
But you're still very young.
I'm young, but, like, I've been through a lot.
That's the thing. It's okay, but I'm turned to me now to say that you've made mistakes that are life-defining.
But they are, actually.
They are, literally. But you're trying to change that.
Mm.
So let's talk about... But you said the first mistake was doing what you had been taught, which was what?
Sex work.
Who taught you sex work?
My biological mother.
Okay. That's a hard one.
It's a hard one.
Because as mothers, we...
You're supposed to protect.
We teach our children how to live and survive on earth. So she gave you that skill as... But she also took you to school. How did you get to... Because you're a qualified educator. And by all accounts, apparently you're actually quite smart.
Let me tell you something.
Yeah.
First of all, she didn't take me to school.
Okay.
She paid for the first month near schooling. Mm. The second month, she told me herself, you must get a man to support you because when I saw him die, there was the reason why with the sex work route.
So what kind of sex work was this, varsity?
Varsity, my first year, literally. That's when I started. She literally told me, what's he, bruh? Mina, angeng sakon kukunayegele o ngezi mali. Awuza mindota na awuzibona umdala. Every time mangilethe indoda umuntu broken lini, she would literally beat me up. Kufanele kuziwe wonke umuntu ukuthi mina ngine boyfriend engenamali. She would ask me ukuthi yena leyo nkane leyo ma uyilokhuzana. Mawiza luzo ilokhuzana ngani uzoyondla ngani. Cool, I understood that. I was like, okay, if indoda broke ayifunakala ekhaya, it's fine, then I must go and get a man ozongisupport. That's when I got my first boyfriend ever city. His name was Lovoyo. He was hamba nge jeep or something.
Emdala,
he was literally old. Give me, but I didn't care because ngizoyithatha kephi imali. Then ngathola omunye umama out of uNkulunkulu, I don't know how. Wathola umama lo, bra, mina ngizokhokhela your fees. It's cool. yabo. So every day, every month, ngizokunikeza imali yakho, every into oyidingayo, like your education, what ngizokunikeza. Nanamhlanje, I haven't spoken with that low mama low. Nayo kusayi mistake yami nguyo. I didn't even follow through with the education that she gave me. Yeah. Not my mother. Look, she's been going around Angel Uti. I'm the one who put you through to, like put you through school. Wara wara wara. Dude, way.
From primary to high school, which is our job as abazali.
I didn't ask you to like
that's what I mean, which it is. I'm trying to understand with Magati. I put you through school. When it is something that you do. You don't praise a fish for swimming. That's something like, that you do. So not even tertiary, which is when most parents start counting. So even that she didn't do.
She didn't do. Tertiary, I was there, bengi one alone. Njongoba, now she's like literally going around as with Amandia that I was sleeping with so I can support myself. Angela konguti mina nguru tinanan.
Inhlamba noma ukhiphe izinto.
Inhlamba le.
Yeah.
Inhlamba go vele, it's something I was doing. I was literally dating Indian people so that I can have money at school.
Okay. Oh, okay. Primary high school.
No, in varsity.
In varsity, okay.
In Gaga.
Which varsity did you go to?
Walter Sisulu University.
Where is that? In the Eastern Cape?
Yeah,
MTAT. Yeah.
And then high school and primary, obviously, there was a job. How was I supposed to
use
Lokuzan?
So that's the first time she said you're now on your own.
Yep.
First year of varsity.
I was pregnant by the time. I was sleeping with those Indian men whilst I was pregnant.
Your first child?
My first child.
Okay. The story that you told another podcast is in terms of how you got pregnant, is that true? Ex-boyfriend?
No, Leo, it was just a memakaya lab.
Yeah.
Begu izinto nje. Nakhona ngisikhathisithandana nalo umfana lo wayengasho ukuthi umuntu ka siswami
yabo. Yeah.
So after mina sengipregnant, wangitshela usiswami wahamba wayekhaya.
Like
wayohamba wayosho ukuthi hayi bo. Mina ngazi ukuthi ngithandana nalo umfana wayesemithisa lo. So mina sengiyithola sekulate indaba
ukuthi and you're already pregnant.
Yeah, I'm already pregnant.
So you're pregnant and you are going to study at Walter Sisulu.
First year, yes.
First year. We are getting so meet, and same it's quite meet. Clear that nothing is going to happen. Agna future with a relationship.
Mm. No, like, being a CEO in a relationship, it was just lento
kutshontshana. Yeah, okay. You have the child. Mfuna ukwazi ukuthi, at what point does your mother stop being your mother?
First year adversity.
There was no event, nothing. We vele nje wathi, so it's adversity.
No, but angithi, asithathe ngokuthini ukuthi from day one, she's been abusive. Yabo.
Yeah.
To her, she doesn't see it as abuse, as umuntu. It's tough love. So, to me, ngize ngibona sengi out of a varsity. Like, sengi se varsity, I'm like, why am I angry towards this person? Because every time I call my name, ngimthatha ngimbekisale. She even asked me, wathi, you even have this ticking time bomb, wara wara, kwathin. I'm like, I didn't understand where everything is coming from. Because Mina, to me, you were my mother. You were raising me, yabo.
Mm.
So I didn't see anything wrong. But I'm like, nah, fam, you were abusive.
It's abuse.
You were abusing me. So ube pumela ngaphandle hambe etown ne. My boy etown, I figured if there's something wrong line, ngizoyicinga. Yezo. Then she will literally beat me up for that. Ukuthi mhlambe ngibeke inkomishi somewhere. Khona this other time abangani bami babefikile bezongivakashela. Wangishayela nje ukuthi angiphekanga. Not because ube bengishayela mina, ubeshayela ukuthi ufuna ukungibukekisa nabangani bami ukuthi kahlahle mina ngiyinto okushawa. First boyfriend wangishaya, she literally wangikhatha my hair, wathi angihambe ngesikoleni nginjalo. Grade 8, she had a boyfriend. Wangishaya yezwa with ijele, kwaphuma igazi so. So that person has been abusive ever since. So Mina, my first time you say vices, I'm like, okay, cool. I don't understand where the anger is coming from.
Yeah, but from her.
Like from
or
me.
Or from you. You just have this. Yeah, yeah.
I have this anger. Angimang pusa when I drink like ngathi ngiyasangana ekhanda.
Yeah.
So started with this thing, didn't I? But I'm a sex work nan, and I started to like group and like isolate myself and be like, okay, cool. Kahlahle, what is wrong? That's when I qala phansi ngabona ukuthi, oh shit.
The way you were raised.
Not ukuthi bowukhulisa. Ngiyaku understand ukushaywa.
Yeah, like, but when you were abused.
And there was this podcast that ngiyibona kuyo. She's like, uthi mina ngihambe ngiya ngokuthi she's HIV positive. Does she know ukuthi when I was 11 years old, she wakwakhathi etholakala ukuthi une-HIV. Guess who? Guess ukuthi ubani ayikhiphela kuye lo engaleyo. It was me. Umisicele, umemcebe khulu esikoleni, they will tell you. Ngafika ngikhala uyinyembezi, ngingama bruises everywhere. Ngaba bangibuza ukuthi hayi bekwenzakalani. Told them, ngathi mina uma ungishayela ukuthi uthe une-HIV. 11 years old, I was in grade 3. Do you get that? So even esikoleni bese bazi ukuthi mina nje vele. But esikoleni mayifikile ufika, hi, my little angel. Because like now mangikhuluma, no one believes me ukuthi lo muntu lo was abusive. Yabo.
Mm.
When I was 12 years old, besibukela amaphoni wakhe. Aphoni. Yabo, those DVDs. Ama-DVD la maningi.
Ama-DVD.
Yebo. Begcwele thenga phansi kombhede. Like la where child is like literally accessible kuyibona. Yabo. So 12 years mina bese ngiyibona ngidonsa ngiyibukele nami ngitshethe into right.
Into right.
Iphone. My brother is 6 years old. Why na 6 by that time? Naye ngesikhathi ebonakala ethola iphone yakhe umama. So ngase ngambuza-ke, if uthi mina ngikhuluma amanga ukuthi you the one who forced me into this. Then ubhuti wami ona 6 years, how come does he watch porn naye? Umphuceleni ifoni. Because the reason why he doesn't have a phone, it's because it has porn in his phone. Unangaki lo muntu, una 6 years. So literally you are destroying all of us. And we're trying to tell you, ukuthi, this is the reason why we are this. It's because of the beliefs that you put in our heads.
I get you now.
It's something that very it's normal.
It's normalized.
Yeah, but so now that I don't wanna do this, now you are taking me because why? Angisafuni manje ukubuyisela imali kuwena because now fanele ngihambe ngiyolala nendoda ukuze ngondle wena. That's the whole argument. Angisafuni ukuyolala nabantu so that I can give you money. It's fucked up. It's really fucked up. And the fucked up part about the whole situation is that she only hates me. It was horrible.
Okay, tell me what you mean.
We were fighting all the time over the show. Apparently I embarrassed her. I don't know what it is. That's the whole argument, that whole lento yami nayo ukuthi siyaxabana nani. Sixabaniswa ukuthi angisafuni ukuyolala nabantu so that I can give you money.
Okay, wakwenzela ukuthi
uthi I've been doing it.
I believe you.
I've been doing it since ngize ngiqali sex work, bra. The reason why I did the sex work was i-approver yakhe so that ngazi ukuthi hayi mhlawumbe uzongithanda.
Bring something to the table now.
It's fucked up, bra. It's really fucked up.
Okay. So you agreed to do this with me because you wanted to clear a few things.
Mm.
And one that's very important to you is the accusation. When I listened to that or when I watched that clip, it's based on assumption. She makes an assumption.
Mm.
She doesn't say she found you guys. Mm. And she doesn't say that you did it.
Mm.
She said she put one and one together and ended up with the number that she got. And the conclusion is that...
Then how is that my fault?
Angas.
How is she hating me this much for assumption?
Because isn't it, so she doesn't say it because she said she put one and one together and she decided it must be truth.
And the fucked up part about the whole situation is that she only hates me.
That is messed up.
In yabo manje njengoba ngikhuluma manje literally uzohamba aye khona endodeni yakhe bayohlala bahlangane bayabenzeni.
So they're still together with your stepfather.
They're still together. So that's yinto engayi understand ukuthi mina kanti why do you hate me this much? Because if when you are capable of going back to indoda yakho, nindoda yakho wena ni right nayo. So mina how did I sleep with him? Just because he saw me as his child engiphi imali esikolweni because you wawuhluleka ungafuna ungiphi imali.
Uthi wayekuphi imali and
why ngiphi imali vele? He was my father. I was asking him, baba, anginayo imali, anginayo indawo
yokuhlala. And you say from 2 years old, he has been the father
figure,
you know.
He has been my father. So manje, how come mase ngisevasithi ngithi baba ngicela 200, ngicela 300 ngifuna ukubhatala lo ngifuna ukuthenga ukudla sekuyi problem manje sengilala naye.
Uthi wena wasuka wayohlala naye.
No. Ngicela ukukutshengisa yabo imthatha ula ePeter Maritzburg ila.
Yes.
So it's easier ukusuka eMthatha ukuya ePeter Maritzburg makhona ama strikes because ama strikes esikolweni bekuyinto yokuthi man strike ile ayisekho indawo yokuhlala nilali ndawo because okay. ben evictwa
okay.
emares
yeah.
So ngaphandle indawo ekuthi isemiyezo it's very expensive ukuhlala phaya ngizoyithatha mina lo mali
okay.
So I will phone my dad baba ngicela ungifakele 300 noma 400 ngizozo ngizohlala lapha until istrike siphele then he will do that. I have a room la mphezulu uhlale behlale building in lama educational ban teacher what
okay.
Like the department of transport of education he does the transport nanani.
Okay.
I have my own room lapha phezulu
scholar transport
eh
scholar transport
oh. No like angithi ngazi lezi zinto zokuthi he travels
okay
I don't know ngathi uleta ama documents and stuff and
oh yeah, yeah. He yeah. Yes he
so he
yeah.
That was his job
yeah uhambisa ama files a pick up a drop off courier service the department but in yeah I
yeah.
Get it
so I have my own room lapha phezulu bekuthi strike mase siphelile then ngisuke elokho ePeter Maritzburg ngihambe ngekhaya ngimini ngihambe ngesikolweni so that's what like upsetile umama
kahle uthi azangumtshela ukuthi uya ku
he's my father why should I tell you fanele ngiqale ngicela kuwe mangisacela imali ukuthi ngithintintini ubabe khona eduzane like ifone yakhe ikhona like ngiyazi ukuthi mangi ngamfonela uzonginipa imali so mina didn't even know ukuthi manje mangicela ukuba bami it's a mistake because mina you see me as competition you see me as capable of sleeping
where was
with
she
you.
Was she at
Ulund? Ulund is like literally very 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 far
so the closest one
is Peter Maritzburg and my dad has money
and I would imagine you wouldn't want to go to loya muntu futhi
no
so
this thing yakhe isidingo sokuya Ulund iPeter Maritzburg iseduzana
okay
ma kune strike baba ngisacela ungifakele imali ngize ngapha ngizothi ukuthi my strike sesiphelile then bese ngibuye ekhaya that's it
and then yena ezumuntu omdala baba must tell his wife ukuthi ingane yaza kimi
kube bekhuluma bebekhuluma bayakhuluma bazi ukuthi ngikhona bazi ukuthi
ngikhona anzange ngixoxe while you were there at all when and I
bese right mina nayo mama mina nayo into engixakayo ukuthi she's bringing up all these things ukuthi I was sleeping with him kodwa bazi kahle mhlawumbe ukuthi ngikubi and ubaba bekhuluma na like ubengekaza ngifuye nje ubaba endlini ukuthi hayi nangu sami kusehlele usekhamsile then I'm not going to tell her mom like there was no way yabo
I get you
so like le anger nale hatred akanayo nale jealousy or ukungibona as a competition angiyazi ukuthi qhamukapi first of all she's the one who told me bangithi she's my best friend apparently she's the one who told me ukuthi my dad has ushukela that's blood, like babies are going to blood sugar or something.
Diabetes,
yes. Yeah. She has it. He has a diabetes and his man who doesn't like stand. So I'm asking her, how does it stand? Because so that's the reason why you hate me.
I don't know.
And then I even told my dad, is like, bruh, just tula. Just shut up about it. Uzos bonela mhlayena, say right to good hi. It's cool. Yabo.
So sizokona gogo.
No, kada shona shona ngo 20 ukhokolozi noma ugogo.
Uma kama.
Washona neminyaka yo 2, mama.
Oh, so akekho uma. So uma yena ukhuliswe bani?
Ukhuliswe abantu basemndenini, abantu bebemhlukumeza nje naye. She has her own traumas.
Do you see which perhaps I'm not justifying it.
I know for a fact ukuthi i-trauma yakhe nanani yonke into iphumela it's rooted from that. But mina ngiyamtshela go to therapy and fix yourself for mina for usengezo for everyone involved because you are now a demon. You are literally chasing everyone out. Akasekho umuntu ofuna ukuye ekhaya. Mina ngidubile ekhaya la ngakhile ekhaya. Like ngakhile izindlu but like now I'm like no fam I'm not going to go back there because unqwahile so she's like a baboon akafuna ukusuka kungathi kwakhe umuzi kakho akuse umuzi wakhe lo waya
yabo. So I'm going 27 years old, what do you mean wakhile ekhaya?
I literally built a house. I built a house and I built urondo kagogo wami. I wanted to build indlu enkulu with the garage.
With what income, with the work that you've been doing?
Yeah, like okay. It was making me a lot of money. So this time ngamtshela ngamnikeza imali ukuthi akangakhela izitini. Wachuza the ipara, the worst parasite lesendaweni ukuthi lizokwakha itini.
That everybody knows.
Mawuzibamba so itini ziyaphuhluka. And remember zonke lezi tin bezokwakha how many room? 4 room. So which means bengafuni vele ukuthi ngiyakhe kwa elondlu le.
Oh, she just made a bad choice, and I mean
bad choice, and she just ubebona vele ukuthi bengafuni ukuthi ngimakhele. Bafanele asho ukuthi no bra angifuni yekela. Nami ngisuke kwasekhaya ngizihambele ngihambe ngiyihlalela somewhere because that's what I'm doing now. I'm like literally ngithe khaya angifuni ukuhlala khona, ngihlala nomuzi wakho, ngithi umuzi kagogo wakho uhlala nawe, ngithi angena ngebhokisi, it's cool, mina I'm good, ngiyahamba. Noma ngabe ngizofela eGoli, I would die eGoli, I would just buy whatever that thing is, ngiyongeniswa phakathi, or just cremate me, I don't care. I don't want to go back there because there is so much eziningi ezenzakalile laphaya. And that person is crazy. Like, she's literally crazy. Ngoba ngitshela nje.
So we've addressed the HIV thing. You're not the one who's spreading the HIV
I'm not.
Stories about her. You definitely did not, you're not the other woman in her life. So those are the two critical things. We clear from her claims on the other podcast before we get to our business of the day.
I'm so angry. Ne? I am so angry. I think I'm good. Mhlambe
as we go on.
As we go on, yeah.
So when last were you home? Okay, let's talk about when last did you see your kids?
Okay.
Yeah.
So my child, lo wentombazane una 9.
Okay.
Uhlala ngakhona ekhaya. So January last year I was there makhaya because bese ngidecidile ukuthi you know what, this life is not for me. I'm good. I'm like, let me just sell everything and just go home because vele there is an apartment that is making me money. So if I'm home, rent free, it's yeah. gonna sustain me.
Yes.
So mangifika ekhaya, I was doing a crystal meth by the time. So my body yehla. Yabo, like bese ngi skinny loko ku skin like mathambo thambo. So ngehla ngayekhaya ngathi ngizohlala ekhaya like ngizodinga nje uthando lama. Aha. It was hell. I was like, okay, cool. Ngiyabuyela mina eGoli ngo March last year.
So you say it was hell. I think wonke umuntu nje everybody would like to believe ukuthi if things get really tough in this Gauteng of ours, we can go home. And you say you discovered last year that you couldn't do that. That was no longer an option for you.
I did go home and it was hell and yeah. I came back.
When you say hell, what do you mean?
It was horrible.
Okay, tell me what you mean.
We were fighting all the time with my mom.
Over what?
Over the show. Apparently I embarrassed her in front of people.
Okay.
It was the argument, ukuthi bra, this is what you did to me and I'm going through this because of you. Bekuzinto eziningi nje, izinto
zokuthi just everyday conflict.
Everyday conflict. I was like, nah fam, ngaze ngacela ukuphuma ibhodo, like ngiziphekele ngiyi-one eceleni.
I know ukuphuma ibhodo is.
Yeah.
I know. That yeah, I'm ukuphuma ibhodo, it's bad.
It was bad. I was like, ngacela wonke umalo, like i-family, ngathi ngicela nize nizongixazulela. Ngicela ukuphumela ibhodo ngihlale ngedwa eceleni, uzoziqhubekela azenzele nokwakhe. And then she was like, hey, ekhaya kwenziwa kanjalo. I was like, ufunani kimi? Because ma angipheki mina, angidli, angithinthini, angingenzi nix ngabo. Yabo. So ukahlahle, why are you holding me hostage? Because wayebona ukuthi if ngiyohlala ngale, I will pack my shit and just leave.
Just go.
And I did that. After they approved me ekhaya, ngavele ngapakisha impahla zami, ngazibuyelela eGoli, ngazosihlalela khona la emalokishini, ngathi ngizomane ngizozifihla just nje for the ukuthi ngihlale ngibe right, ngizoba ne-mental health yami izoba right.
So that was the last time you saw your 9-year-old, was last year?
That was last year.
2023, January.
Yeah, March.
You speak to her?
Like, I'm really scared
to talk to her.
I am really scared. I'm terrified because we have Agashangit. After, when I was there at home, my mom, watata, do you know Telemba? That sharp thing.
A machete, a panga.
Le Yorkshire, like Kilokuzan. Like these things. Mo centa.
Yeah.
Yeah, she literally held that thing over my head. She wanted to kill me. And she have confessed over and over and over again over the phone. Ukuthi she literally wants me dead. So ngabacela ekhaya kwekhaya lengane yami ukuthi please don't let my child go to that
woman.
And they still letting her go. And I don't know ukuthi ngizoqala ngapi with court and what, but I'm hoping somehow family court will just help me, because now I feel like I'm in a good place. Because I won't use my teaching degree, because no one... First of all, you all guys are putting us through trauma. We're not working because of you. We are... so that I can fight with her. And then now you want our baby daddy, bam. Bezela, we show, so that you can make content. I will make a lot of content.
Oh, you get 80%. You and Chris Axel.
You're bullying me and you're bullying other people. My life is just picking up. I'm going to school. There's something that is vulagala. I want to go back to school. Because I won't use my teaching degree, because no one...
You don't know that. Let's park that. I'm just saying, you don't...
Yeah, let me just go do something with, like, computers, because, like, I'm very smart when it comes to those things. I know what things was born ill. I know something will come up. Mm. And then I'll have to just get full custody for my daughter.
Okay.
My son is okay. My son is good. Uhlala Eastern Cape, and he has a father Eastern Cape.
Yeah, so you're mtata, we're back.
And for now, it's a just bongo, so he can take his family, like, clean. Because they literally take care of him, like, all right, he's healthy, and I got no access to that woman, so I'm good.
Okay, that's good at least. So that's what you'd fight about. And you mentioned which one of the things you fought about was the show, My Body Works For Me. How much were you paid for that show?
I was paid 50,000 for the whole season, season one.
Season one. And that's why you didn't come back for season two, because you felt it was not enough.
I didn't come back for E-Reunion.
E-Reunion.
Because that...
Is this season two on now? I think it is.
Yeah, season two is on, but I was like, nah, fam, I'm not...
Are you not doing it?
Yeah, because I'm going to talk about with the reunion. Because I saw, Wuti, like, they're going to scam. I don't know the law, but, like, to me, I felt like in a way, because you made me sign a contract with Ihani TV. And then now the show is Lalagu Show Mix. I understand the whole thing. It's
adult content.
No, Ibizwang multi choice. Yeah, it's the same company, so they are allowed to sell what.
Yeah.
But I prefer Uguti Mumetwa Nastya Laksasekalin Uguting is Katinizo sign a contract le, then Lentele Izo Yagu Show Mix. So we didn't know Uguti, we were literally signing to multi choice as a whole, not Ihani TV. So I felt ngati they exploited me in a way. And then we reunion, they told me they would give me 6,000. I'm like, nah, fam. Remember ukuthi le show ukuthi niyifake kuyiphi channel and how many people are watching it. It's literally number one. I know for a fact that it made a lot of money. So why are you giving me 6,000 and then not my rights, not my royalties? Just 6,000, George, for ukuthi nje.
Whereas you signed a contract with the one NTT season one, platform.
Season one, I don't care. Well, I signed it. Like, they literally coerced me with if I signed. Because Bangnese and I'm planning to ask what I signed. And then we start the show. Yeah, but I didn't even have time to, like, read throughout. I was like, 50,000. I've never held that amount of money. I was like, God, I signed my Bangnese. Then, Pelagwe show, I'm like, nah. First of all, you all guys are putting us through trauma. We're not working because of you. We are crying every day because you are setting up a script. Niti Uzot Usamge is doing this, is going on the show, is what. And then I have to respect that and like doing it. So if me now, in a situation where I have to cry every day, I'm going to cry every day because you're literally exposing me to my trauma every day. But because in Ngengele 50,000, I have to like abide to the rules. I'm like, nah, ni right. And 6,000 yen igcinini.
No counseling was offered.
Season 2, I'm good. Nah, yo lo counseling leyo. They buy and for like, I think it was 30 minutes just for content. Because I told them, Mina, I want to go to therapy so I can deal with my own issues. But I don't want this on camera. Did they not force ukuthi no bra? This is your script. Script ako seat. Fanele uhambe uye Pretoria.
Who wrote the script?
It was the producers. There's that girl producer ngamazuba igamise ngimkhohle because I literally hate her. Angibengasafuni niks nje ezonghlanganisa naye because I can see ukuthi lo muntu lo she's using me to a point ukuthi I know she's very smart. She is smart, yabo. Because the way she knows how to like kwenza content yakhe. But at the same time, ubu smart bakhe, it's damaging us. Because I was literally crying every day.
Over what you're being exposed to?
Yes, you're taking me to, I'm a therapist for my trauma. You're taking me to a lawyer for ukuthi give up inganzam. You susuma wamekhaya wamletha la so that I can fight with her. And then now you want our baby daddy bam. Bezela, we show so that you can make content. Yeah. What I told you for effect, angifuni. I don't want anything. Ezohlanganisa, ezobaveza ukuthi bawoba because of the work that I do. I know for ukuthi mabephumela ngaphandle bazoba exposed and it's gonna be hard for them. As for my kids, nakhona it's gonna be hard.
And you told the producers
I this. Told them that. But did they not bang mamela ngaze ngalugcineni ngathi na angeke ngize ngize ngiyenze lonto la. I'm not gonna bring I'm a
the baby fathers dad. Of your children.
Bazo zala for show. I never phone in. Kuthi nenze imali. Now is. Kwathi nge reunion ngibona wonke umuntu useshaya ngama Audi ngama BMW. So yithina ke ilima zama 50,000. I was like, nah. Season 2 wena ugcineni sengiyona.
Ngoba labantu bama Audi the production team.
The production team. They are born and roots manje bayimali ayebusizi ekukhalanga kubo. So yithina bebe exploited but it was our story.
Ah, but we don't know. Mhlawumbe abantu kudala ba
Oh.
Bafaka i-deposit yemoto.
My.
Okay. I'm sorry you went through that.
It's cool. If it wasn't for it, ngaba zangeze ngisithole again. I finally found myself. And
okay, so we've cleared the issues with your mom, the accusations that she made. We're not going to get into all the other stuff that she said. Mm. We're not going to breathe life into it.
Yeah.
So what now, Samke? You young, you smart, man.
Very.
How do you get into OnlyFans? Did you make a lot of money with OnlyFans?
Close to 300K, I think, in just 1 year.
Unamang. How do you get... So, I subscribe to OnlyFans, and then I get access into your content.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it?
That's it.
And then how do you make your money?
You pay. For me, it was a genius move because I will make a lot of content, and then each and every content, you need to pay for it. Maybe $10. $12, $20, $30.
So I pay each time I see you and the revenue share with you. The platform gives you a portion of what I pay.
80%.
Oh, you get 80%?
They take 20%.
Oh,
yeah, and then it goes straight to my account and then that's good.
Okay, how much a month? Let's...
No, if we are now go to content.
How much content? Oh, how much?
If content is like njalo yayenza and like
there's people who want it.
And you that evil witch lapaya go Twitter, you fighting everyone, those big accounts so that you can have like amehlo so that you can have people who are gonna subscribe. That was my life. You see, like mobile and Twitter yami before, I was always in fights.
So, and that translated into views.
Views.
For you.
But people didn't get it. So, I mean, I was just using them.
You and Chris XL, was that what you guys were doing?
No.
Was that a genuine fight?
Chris XL, at first, it was just nje, loko na loko, we're friends. And then I saw a little part of it, ukuthi he was bullying me. Yabo. So I didn't mind it at first because I thought Utahaveli has like a million followers, so it's cool. But Masangibona, no man, like this person is literally bullying me. And then I came after him, I'm like, bruh, like you're bullying me and you're bullying other people. Why are you doing that, Yabo? So Naege, he came back because like he's the man. He doesn't want to be told by a woman.
Are you guys friends offline?
like we are friends still. Yeah. Man. So after the fight, like we fought to a point ukuthi it was a bad fight, yabo. Like wagcina sephuma nezinto. Nah, he was the reason why I got to know and acknowledge ukuthi my mom was a sex worker and she was a sex worker and wangifaka kwindaba ze sex work and literally I chose sex work to get her love.
You went, oh, you just thought it was just normal.
No, ngisho ukuthi Chris XL is the one who opened my eyes.
You didn't know that your mom was...
I didn't. Because that's how much of a... Like, I brainwashed her kid was that. Ukuthi just yonkinte ngwenzela yona, ngwenzela because you're my child. And yonkinte fanele uyenze or uyisho, you're going to say it because I said so.
Yeah, okay.
So, after that fight with Chris XL, I literally ngavuleka amehlo ukuthi, oh, shit.
That's... What that was.
That is the kahle nangu umuntu oyiproblem kwasekuqaleni yabo. So that's when I started to like follow up. That's when I got into drugs because I wanted to kill myself at some point because it was too much yabo. To like remember everything eyenzakala nan like step by step. So I went to drug addict, crystal meth. That's when I went back home.
Crystal meth kunje yini?
Crystal meth is that drug esetshenziswa Hitler. He wanted his like his soldiers with bangalali. Just focus on one thing.
Is it?
Yeah. So manje
you smoke it, you
put it in a pipe and then
okay.
And then yeah, again. So it messes with your brain game. There's a lot of things it does to you.
That's why you lost weight.
Yeah.
How was it helping you?
It was helping me cope because if it wasn't for it, I was going to kill myself. When if mangatua manje ubuzo umuntu and then hear my mother say those things to other people, they would definitely kill themselves. So, yeah, I think cocaine now, I'm a crystal meth, it was good. So by March, I came back. I stayed with a friend, Utembi. Then June, I moved alone in Maboneng. That's when I met Muach. The love of my life.
Here's you saved as my love. Do you see it?
Yeah.
So we are here now. Yeah. What do you want for yourself?
I want to go back to school.
Mm-hmm.
There's an academy that I've recently just researched Batebazovula ngo February 19, I think.
Yeah, that's yeah.
And then I'm gonna apply, I'm gonna do the test, I'm gonna start with the ilokuzam. I'm gonna code now.
Yeah. I think you would be great at it.
I'll be awesome.
Yeah. And what are you going to do about your digital past? You can't erase it. How do you can you get all those videos of you are you still on Simplify? What is it?
That's the problem with my Twitter account. I opened activated this two-factor authorization.
Yeah.
At that time, I was paying for a subscription at 200. So I didn't pay the that month. And then E2A factor. Young log out to like sending messages, I'm a verification codes to SMS.
Okay.
So they want me using an app or just a backup code. A backup code that they gave me, but I didn't save it.
Yeah.
So literally I'm logged out of my big account, 380,000 people on Twitter, where it has all of my content and the part engfungus delete everything. Delete my own. Yeah, that's that. Learn and she.
What is stopping you? You must
have an app that you can generate a code with.
Yeah.
Or use a backup code. They gave me an email, but I didn't save the backup code. So now I'm like every day I'm contacting Ulo Twitter support guys. They haven't responded, so
we'll talk about that. I'm sure. So you want to delete that?
I
want to
delete my
and life. Your OnlyFans one.
I want to delete now. Oh, OnlyFans, yeah, now I can't access it because they saw Guti. I was trying to withdraw money using another phone, so they were skeptical about her. Who are you? The picture with holding your ID. And I don't have my ID. So maybe a month or two so that I can redo my ID so I can come back. So when EITM say buyile, ngiyabuyisela, I withdraw the money elaphaya, then I delete everything. Ngiyaw delete nje OnlyFans ne account yami no Twitter mangathiwa ngiyabuyisela. I will delete everything.
I'm sure there's ways of recovering your Twitter access. There has to be.
I've tried everything. Because there's no backup code. Anginayo nalo app generator. What? I don't have it.
I have no idea what you're talking about, but we'll figure it out when we're done here.
Okay, cool.
Okay. Okay, so you want to, because I think that's important. You need to be able to do that. Do you think it is important for you to delete all of that and then for you to start afresh? But you're not going to wait for that to be resolved. You're going to start your new life now. Do you still want that big house and that BMW?
Oh, my tunan. Oh, in. That was me, ne? No, I don't want that life, Mina, anymore. Because, in a way, I felt like, okay, I was listening to this podcast. There's this genius guy, I was say America, who's a musician. He was like, when it comes to money, you can never have enough. Yabo.
Mm-hmm.
If 1,000 is 2,000, if you find a million, it's going to be 2 million. So it never stops. Yabo.
Mm.
So me, I had money, 300K, and I did things, like my drugs. I no longer want to be exposed to that. Yabo.
Mm.
But manga twang ala pants where now work, fine, I want to follow the system. Now I wanna be in the matrix. It's cool.
Are you happy to be in the matrix, as you call it?
No, I'm happy to be in the matrix
because you understand you have to exist within the matrix.
You have to
get your salary at the end of the month. You need to build exactly. Your credit record, so, your financial.
I was brainwashed. Now I'm back then. I was like, God, I'm in okay. Ubalo, there's this guy lo. Ulo manlo go Twitter manlo or famous kakhulu ohlanyayo naye.
I have no idea who that is.
He's always talking about the matrix, but he doesn't even understand the matrix. Now I was like, hey, matrix,
So yeah, because you have to belong into a system.
You have to, yabo.
And the system requires that you put in maximum effort for a salary.
But me nage, I call myself a genius. I don't wanna work hard. I work smart, nje.
There's nothing wrong with that.
So, in a way, nakhona ukesikolweni and like learning coding, it's not like I'm going to go and fetch for a job, yabo.
You want to
there's
do
something
this.
I want to do or develop or something that I would do, yabo, nje izinto because I know my way around the internet goods, there's like a lot of money.
I don't doubt that. Yabo. Yeah.
So, now I want to be relaxed and just chilled because now I'm no longer doing it for people. I no longer have to like buy an apartment so that I can
show off
and like get people's validation. I don't have to buy a car now because I want to be that girl. I don't have to buy like iPhone 14, 15 so that I can like belong. I'm just because I think love for me, it was just everything that I needed because he was my therapy. He helped me through a lot. Like, I think we all need that someone who's by support system because literally I was alone. Mean. And the friends that I had, I thought Uguti, they're just there for my interest, but they were not.
How'd you guys meet?
My man.
Mm.
So, I'm getting a
big answer. You got the most beautiful smile.
When I talk about him.
No, generally, I'm just looking at you. You're a very pretty girl. But how did you and him meet?
Okay, I can see we were sharing a building
in Maboneng.
And then when Clarice 6 and Clarice 1, and then he's like, I saw you on Twitter and I have Jägermeister and we'd come over. Mm. And I won't like lock the door. I'm like, okay, yes, and I guess what time. No, I just go to Yadal. Then Mang Soga la Pong, eh? Mang Figgins in her, Mang it, I will find a lot of umflapper and guy, and that's okay.
It's light skinned.
It's light skinned. Yeah. I'm like, hi, bo. Where are you? What, Tunjan Mounje? Mang it, I will.
Tunjan Mounje. Okay.
He's so cute. Like, oh, Mang is a Kuluma with that voice, that deep voice. I'm like, oh.
He's very cute. I'm like,
yes. And he's nice. He's smart. He's a genius. Oh, he's very smart. And he cares. He's everything. Yeah, like a person who need. Yeah. So
and then
like,
you guys met, and that's how you guys hooked up.
And then
did you decide to move in together?
A month later.
Okay.
2 weeks later, I think. Yeah, 2 weeks later.
It happens.
Mm-hmm.
Are you safe? Do you feel?
I am very safe. I actually live with this family now.
Okay.
And they love me to death.
That's nice.
Like I've found a family, so like somewhere I belong. Like this is where I belong now. So now,
and about way of your history, and they're accepting as you of you as you are.
Yep. I know they know everything, and I told them everything, and they know the fight with my mom, and they accept like that right.
I'm happy.
I'm happy for myself. Thank you for once. So
you're going to register at school. You're going to delete every piece of yourself that you no longer find relevant.
Mm-hmm.
You're happy to work and earn a salary mm-hmm. like everybody else.
Like everybody else?
Look, you only try yourself. That's fine. You had to learn that. It's like everybody else. It's hard. It's frustrating. It's a whole capitalist system. It's exploitative.
Mm.
You put in maximum effort for minimum. But that is the way to live without betraying yourself. But as you say, you never knew yourself outside of that context.
I didn't.
And I'm so happy for you. And I'm happy that I have your number and you have mine.
Thank you.
And then we'll talk. And you'll figure it out.
Really?
And I'm still figuring it out. And you must figure it out. You just figured it out in your own way.
And I haven't actually, because Nami, I'm still struggling.
Yeah.
Like identity-wise.
Exactly. So you'll be fine.
Nah.
Mm. Thank you.
Just that now she's, I think she's a demon in a way. She's like trying to my peace.
But you've said, there's nothing you can do for her now. There's nothing.
Like nabantu abamletha kuma podcast abam suggested phela ukuthi she must go to therapy. She can't hold on to pain all this time because pain it kind of clouds you.
It consumes you.
Yonke ama decisions owenzayo
are based on that.
Anger and like hate, what. Just go to therapy and like heal yourself so that you can be better for us, better for yourself. That's it.
Okay.
It's just me and my brother, and my brother is just 11.
Mm.
And he's already damaged. He's fucked up now. Which is a pity, but somehow in his 18-year-old, number teens, is gonna figure something out now. And now every soul chooses, bruh.
Do you believe in God?
I do.
Okay.
I believe in the infinite power, the infinite energy.
Yes.
Not the one in the Bible.
Mm.
The one is evil.
And sometimes when things are a lot for us, you leave it to a higher power and pray and hope that he also finds his way and finds you in a better space to be able to be a big sister to him and a mother to your kids and a good person to yourself. I need you to be a good person to yourself, not to anybody else.
That is hard.
But to be kind to yourself.
That is like that.
You're not defined by those videotapes and that content that's still on OnlyFans or everything else that we've seen on YouTube. It doesn't define you.
It's hard though. Like abantu, they can literally say, it's easy to just look at yourself in the mirror and be like, accept yourself and appreciate. No, it's not. You see among all the scars and why do it now.
Are you seeing somebody now? A therapist, just somebody, not even a therapist, just somebody you can just kind of like say.
Ah, Moach is my therapist.
No, we'll talk about that as well. Thank you, ne? Thanks for coming out.
Thank you for trusting me. I've never had like an interview that is just flowing and nice. Everyone is just gonna.
Yeah, there's no need for that. There's enough of that going on. We're good here.
We're good. Yeah.
Thank you very much.